Hi friends, welcome back to Angular Hero to Superhero series. If you are a beginner trying to learn Angular, there is another series, Angular Zero to Hero, in which I have explained all the basic concepts. You can find the link in the description. In this Angular series, Hero to Superhero, I am focusing on advanced concepts. In this video, I am going to tell you the step-by-step process to create this dashboard in Angular. Okay, let's code together. In this dashboard, I have used some charts. In my last video, I have explained how to use ng2 charts in Angular. And so, I have used Highcharts here so that I can explain how to integrate Highcharts in Angular. Highcharts is free for personal use. But if you want to use that for commercial purpose, you need to purchase a license. Okay, let's start. First, let me create an Angular application. Do we need routing? Actually, if you see, we have many pages. So ideally, I need routing. But in this demo, I'm going to use only this page. And so I'm going to choose no. And let me choose SCSS. Let it create the application. In the meantime, let us see this dashboard and see what are the components we need to create. First, we need a header component. And we need a side nav component and a main component. Let's also create these widgets as separate components. These four can be in a single component. Okay, we can see the application is created. Let me go into the application folder. Now let me create the needed components quickly. ngGC header. And then ngGC site-nav. Then ngGC main. Now we need to create the widget components. First, let me create the top widgets component. And then sales by month component. Sales by category component. Last few transactions component. And finally, top three products component. Okay, let me start the server. Let's first set up our global CSS. I'm going to use some Google fonts. And so let me import that URL first. After that, let me add the CSS to reset the browser specific styles. And let me use the XO font family and a background color. In the app component, let me delete all the code. Now let us put the components in the right places. In the app component, let me create a container. Inside that, a header and a main container. Inside header, let me add the header component. And inside main container, let me add a div for side nav and another div for main. And let me add the respective components inside. And so we can see this. I have already created another video in which I have explained about creating a movie rating application. But in that, I got some feedback that I'm concentrating more on CSS. So in this video, I'm going to concentrate less on CSS. I can explain the important CSS I have used, but I will place the entire code in Git. And so you can take that code if you want to get the right CSS. So let me copy the CSS. Here, if you see, I have used flux so that the side nav and main containers will be placed side by side. And I have used some width, height, background color, box shadow, and a media query. I'm using media query to make this responsive up to tablet level. Now you can see this, but when I add CSS to header component, this gap will be corrected. And so let me move to header component. Here, let me create a header div. Inside that, a div for logo and another div for holding the user details, in which I have two more divs. Let me hard code some values. Here also, I have used flux, so that the logo will be in the left and the user div will be in the right. I have used a darker color background for header. And I have used border radius to make the user image in a circle. But instead of image, I'm using the initials only. And so we can see this. Okay, let's move to side nav. In side nav, let me create a parent div called nav items. Inside that, let me add few children divs called nav item. Let me have some navigation items. And so we can see this. It would be good if we show some icons in front of each nav items. For that, we can use Font Awesome library. Let me explain how we can add Font Awesome library in Angular. First, let me open the documentation. And let me look into the compatibility table to find out the right version. My Angular version is 13. And so I need to use this Font Awesome version. Let me use this command and add the version to install Font Awesome. Let me go for this. And let me choose version 6. Finally, let me choose all the free icons. Okay, it is installed. We can also see the Font Awesome module has been already imported in the app module. And so we can start using Font Awesome in our application. Let me also start the server. If you see in this example, they are importing FA coffee icon from this library. And they are assigning that to a variable and they are using FA icon in the template and binding that variable to icon property like this. Let's follow the same approach. Now we can see the icon, but we don't want the coffee icon. So let me choose the right icons for our application and use that. So we can see the icons are changed. Now let me use some CSS. Here you can see I have used FA icon tag to apply some style for the icons. And I am using a pseudo class hover to change the background color on mouse over. So we can see this. Now let's move to the main component. In the main component, let me create three divs. Top section, middle section, and bottom section. Inside the top section div, let me add the top widgets component. And inside the middle section, let me create two widgets, left and right. Inside left, let me put the sales by month component. And inside right, let me use the sales by category component. Similarly, inside the bottom section, let me create two divs, left and right. And let me put the last few transaction component and top three products component. And so we can see this. Let me put some CSS. Most of them are media queries to make it responsive. Other than that, I have used flex to place the containers side by side. I have used some background color, border radius, box shadow, margin, etc. And so we can see this. Now let's work on the top widgets. In the top widgets component, let me create a widget container and inside that a widget div. Inside that, let me create an icon div and a value div. Inside value div, let me create a top div and a bottom div. Inside icon, let me use a Font Awesome icon. Let me use the location. Let me also add some text to top and bottom divs as well. So we can see this. Let me add some CSS. Here also I have used flex, and so the other widgets will be placed side by side. And so we can see this. Let me copy this widget div and paste three more times. Now we can see this. Let me quickly change the icons and these text. Now we can see the icons and other text are changed. Let me add some background color to each widget. For that, let me add some classes and add some CSS. And so we can see this. Let me change the font color also to white. Now looks good. Let's move to this widget. Here I am going to use a line chart. For that, we need to install Highcharts. Let me use this Angular Highcharts library. Actually, I couldn't find the compatibility table in the NPM documentation. First, I just installed Angular Highcharts, but it was throwing error because it installed this version, which is compatible with version 14 only. But my Angular version is 13. So I uninstalled that and tried with version 13.0.1. That was working fine. So let me install this version using the npm command. It is installed. Let me start the server and go to app module to import the chart module from Angular Highcharts. Now we can start using Highcharts in this application. Let me go to the sales by month component. In that, let me import the chart class from Angular Highcharts library. And I can create a chart using the chart constructor, like this. To the constructor, let me pass an object with some properties. First, chart property, for which I can have a subproperty type, which is going to be line. Then let me add a title with text month by sales. Now we need to add the x-axis and y-axis. In x-axis, we can add the categories. In our case, it is going to be the list of months. In y-axis, let me add a title with text revenue in dollar. This will be shown in the chart. Now comes the important property series, which is an array of objects. In the first object, let me add a name. Again, I need to specify the type, which is going to be line. And then a data, which is an array to hold the value for each label. Let me specify some values. Now in HTML, I need to create a div. And then I need to bind this variable with the chart property like this. And so we can see the chart is getting displayed. But it is going out of the container. Let's specify some height. Okay, let's also give some padding to this container. Okay, looks good. You can see it is showing this credit here. To hide this, Highcharts is providing us a property. Using that, we can hide this. We can also add more series. Let me add two more. And so we can see this. Like how we customized the NG2 charts in the last video, we can also customize this Highcharts. Let me change the color of these lines to match our theme color. For that, I can specify the individual colors to the series. Now we can see the colors are changed and it looks good. Let's move to the next widget, sales by category. Here also the approach is similar. And so let me copy the line chart quickly. And so we can see this. Now let me change the chart properties. First, let me change the type to pie. This is going to be category-wise sales. In x-axis, let me have 5 categories now. In y-axis, let me change this to percent. In series, let me delete the existing objects and create one empty object. For that, let me add a type property, which is going to be pie. And then a data property, which is again an array of objects. For the first object, let me have a name, a Y value, and a color. Similarly, let me have values for other 4 categories as well. And so we can see the pie chart. Let us move to the next widget, last few transactions. This widget is not having any chart. This is just having a table, which we are going to create using just few divs. For that, first let me create a transactions div. Inside that, let me create a title div. And so we can see this. Let's add some CSS to match the other widget's title. I actually inspect this to find out the correct CSS values. Okay. Now let me create a transaction wrapper div. And inside that, transaction div. In the TypeScript component, I have created this array. Usually, we will get this as JSON from backend. I'm going to use ng4 to loop this array and show each transaction. Inside transaction div, let me create divs for showing image, title, price, shop location, and status. Let me also bind the respective properties. For shop location, let me add 2 more divs, one for shop and one for location. And let me also bind the respective properties. And so we can see this. We need to add CSS to correct these. Let me add. You can see I have used display flux, and so all the items display side by side. I have used a border bottom, and I have used object fit cover so that the image won't distort. And so we can see this. This is going out of the container. And so let me add a height and overflow to this wrapper. Now we can see a scroll bar. And we can add a logic to show different colors for different status. For that, let me add some classes. And in the template, let me add ng class to add the respective class based on transaction status. And so we can see this. Finally, let's move to the last widget, top three products. Here we are going to use the bar chart. The implementation is same. And so let me quickly copy the pie chart we have created. And so we can see this. Now let me change the chart property values. First, let me change this type to bar and let me reduce the height. Let me change the title and let me have three categories in x-axis. I don't want to display anything in the y-axis, and so let me leave that blank. In series, let me change the type to bar, and in data, we need only three objects. So let me delete the other two and change the values accordingly. That's it. We can see this. It would be good if you hide this. For that, we can use the property show in legend false. Looks good now. Finally, let's add some CSS to make this scroll bar looks beautiful. We need to add this CSS in the styles.css file. And so we have completed our dashboard. Again, if you want the code for this, you can get it from the Git. You can find the link in the description. Hope you like this video. Please subscribe and support me. I'll be back with another concept soon. Thank you. Bye.